The DS3231 real-time clock model can be used to make a timed automatic start-stop controller. To make this controller, you will need 12 volts power supply, Arduino Nano adapter board, rotary encoder, I2C LCD model, DS3231 ROTC model, relay model, jumper wires, bulb, and bulb holder. The automatic start-stop controller is put together using this circuit diagram. First, the Arduino Nano is mounted on the Arduino Nano adapter board. Get some female-to-female jumper wires and strip off the middle insulation. Connect one of the jumper wires to VIN of the Nano, two of them to GND. Another 2 to 5 volts. 1 to A5, which is the same as SCL, and the last to A4, the same as SDA. Then the rotary encoder is connected to the Nano. VCC of the encoder is connected to 5 volts of the Nano. GND to GND of the Nano. S1 to D2. S2 to D3. And key to D4. Next is the I2C LCD and the DS3231 ROTC modules. Connect their GND to the Nano's GND. Their VCC to 5 volts of the Nano. Their SDA to A4. And their SCL to A5. Connect DC plus of the relay module to VIN of the Nano, DC minus to GND, and IN to D12. Connect 12 volts positive to VIN of the Nano, and 12 volts negative to GND. The relay contacts COM, NO, or NC can connect 110 or 220 volts AC to home appliance. For this demonstration, the NO contact of the relay is connected to 110 or 220 volts AC life. The COM contact is connected to one end of a light bulb, and the other end of the bulb is connected to 110 or 220 volts AC neutral. The control logic retrieves the date and time values from the ROTC module and displays them on the LCD. Adjustments to correct the date and time and setting of the start-stop time is done using the rotary encoder. The relay module turns on and off the light bulb when the set start and stop time is reached. The set start and stop time is also displayed on the LCD. The program from tutorial 21, I2C LCD crystal display resolved for the ROTC module and the rotary encoder has been modified. Room 2 initializes variable row to 1, cool and rec to 0 at power up. Room 4 ensures the relay connected to Y auto is off at power up. Room 5 compares the actual months and dates with the set start months and dates values or the actual day of the week with the set start day of the week alongside the hour and minutes to turn on Y auto when there is a match. This comparison is also done by room 7 for the set stop time to turn off the relay. The encoder instruction in room 9 uses variable count for the adjustment and setting of date and time, and X menu for navigating through the menu. In room 11, when the encoder knob represented by X menu is held down for 2 seconds, the settings menu is accessed with C menu circular counter for C menu equal to 2 up to 17. In room 13, when C menu is equal to 1, the changing value of variable count is used to change between displaying set start stop date and time and the actual date and time. Thus, when count is either 0 or 1 due to count skip of the encoder in room 15, the values of start hour, minute, month, date, and day are separated into tens and units and converted to ASCII. Similarly, the values of stop hour, minute, month, date, and day are separated into tens and units and converted to ASCII in room 17. In room 19, when C menu is still 1 and count is either 0 or 1 and the coil Y auto is not on, the characters of start and start values of the hour and minute are sent to the first row of the LCD. Room 21, we send the start values of month, date, and day to the second row of the LCD. When the coil Y auto is on, room 23, we send the characters of stop, the stop values of the hour and minute to the first row of the LCD. While room 25, we send the stop values of month, date, and day to the second row of the LCD. Room 27 retrieves the values of second, minute, hour, day, date, month, and year values from the ROTC module, separates them into tens and units, and converts them to ASCII. In settings mode, when C menu is 2 and 3, in rooms 29 and 31 respectively, the start values of the hour and minute can be adjusted, separated to tens and units, and converted to ASCII. The characters of set start time is then sent to the first row of the LCD in room 33, and the start values of the hour and minute are sent to the second row of the LCD in room 35. The greater than character is displayed before the hour value when C menu is equal to 2 to point to its adjustment, and before the minute value when C menu is equal to 3. When C menu is equal to 4, 5, and 6 in rooms 37, 39, and 41 respectively, similar operations are done for the start values of month, date, and day, and sent to the first and second rows of the LCD by rooms 43 and 45. Rooms 47 to 63 carry out similar operations of the set start for the set stop when C menu is 7 to 11. In rooms 65, 67, 69, 71, 73, and 75, when C menu is equal to 12 to 17 respectively, the respective values of the actual hour, minute, date, month, year, and day are adjusted and sent to the ROTC module. Rooms 77 and 79 send the actual date and time values when count is either 2 or 3, and the adjusted values to the LCD, with the greater than symbol pointing to the adjusted values. Room 81 turns on the LCD backlight, and room 83 handles the displaying of the characters on the LCD. Finally, rooms 85 saves the set start and stop values of minute, hour, date, day, and month to the EEPROM. The selected microcontroller type is Atmel AVRO 80Mega32828PDIP, which is also suitable for Arduino Nano with a crystal frequency of 16 MHz. The pin assignment is as shown. when the program is uploaded to the Arduino Nano, the set start time and date is shown on the LCD. Rotating the encoder knob will display the actual date and time. Hold down the encoder knob for 2 seconds and release it to enter the settings menu. Adjust the start hour and minute. Press the knob to adjust the start month, date and day. Press the knob again to adjust the stop hour and minute, and then the stop month, date and day. Then press the knob to enter the menu where the correct hour, minute, date, month, year and day can be set. A final press of the encoder knob will exit the settings menu to display the start date and time. When the time matches the set start date and time, the light bulb is turned on. The light bulb is turned off when the time matches the set stop date and time. The operation will occur once a month and once every week. Thanks for watching. Did you enjoy this tutorial? Please hit the like button. Also, hit the subscribe button if you have not, and the bell next to it for future notifications.